Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Wally McGee My Career series here in NBA 2K14 on the PS4. Yeah, we had a Wally McGee episode yesterday as well, but I had fun playing and I decided I wanted to play some more games. So here we are, 2 days in a row, Wally McGee. I'm sure you're not complaining. Somebody is complaining though. Look at this, Magic Johnson. I gotta say, I just don't think Wally World 42 is passing the ball the way he's capable of. It would be in the best interest of the team if he stepped it up in that area. What are you talking about? This guy's had triple doubles lately. Wow. Okay. Well, Magic Johnson thinks he needs to step it up in the assists area, and I guess if anybody would know, he would be the guy, as he is the king of the assist right there in his playing days. So, taking on another LA team, the Los Angeles Clippers here. And we are finally at home. Ah, home sweet home. So we had that long road trip, and we got back home finally at the end of the last episode. And now we're taking on the Clippers, looking for another win. And there's a nice assist right off the bat. So there you go. Ty Corbin's like, you know, show him he's wrong. Let's get 12 or more assists. And that is the dynamic goal. So that's what Wally's going to run with tonight. As he's already got one. Oh, let's make it two as he finds a big man right there for another easy one, and they're out to an 8-4 lead. Let's see if he can make it three. Gives it to Favors. No, Favors will give it back, and oh, nice bounce pass and the reverse slam. That was nifty right there. Nice play, and he's already got three assists. He's looking for his fourth. Hayward underneath. Yep, there you go. So he's starting off with some crazy assist skill here right at the beginning of the game, already with four. Trying to get some points too. Nah, he's going to kick that out to Favors, and it's five assists. Well, if he's going to get 12 or more in this game, you got to like his pace so far, as he's got five. But here he's cutting to the basket and looking for the slam of his own. Nice job giving this pass off. And then Favors, kind of over his head, gives it to Wally, who's wide open in the lane. Nice job right there. And it's a 35-27 lead. Nice bounce pass for a great assist right there. As Hayward's running the floor, McGee gets a strip here and a steal. Here we go, we got numbers, and he's going to just wait till Cantor can take it. And he puts it away. So 55-48 now, second quarter almost over. Jumper for Wally McGee is good. And it's a 57-50 halftime lead for the Jazz.
Hello and welcome. We've got a great one underway at Energy Solutions Arena. At the midway point, the Jazz are playing well. Just outstanding efficiency offensively. They're having a field day. It's just that simple. A tremendous first half for the Magician. The bucket looks about 5 feet wide for him. He hasn't missed one shot. Can you believe it?
Yeah, so the halftime show is pretty high on Wally McGee's talents in the first half as well. Getting this one to Cantor, who is going to make the shot. It's another assist for Wally. He's got 8 of those 12 that he's gunning for now. Can he make it 9 right here? Oh, yeah. Yes, he can. It's a 65-54 lead. How about this? Utah is taking it to the Clippers right now. Pass to Gobert. He's going to hit his jump shot. Wow. He's elevating everybody's game right here now. He's got the double-double with 19 points, 10 assists. He's got those 5 rebounds, too. Triple-double isn't out of the question. What a pass right there to Cantor. That was nifty right there. And he's got an 11 assist now. He's just one away from what coach asked him to get. Oh, no, he got it right there. Feeds Favors. He flushes it home. So that challenge is done. Now, I seriously doubt that Wally McGee would call out Magic Johnson after this game. It's just not in his nature. But that's got to feel good. You know, you're going to say that I can't dish the ball with the best of them. Well, I'm going to go out and show you with my actions. I'm not going to sit there and complain and, you know, say something bad about Magic. No. Wally's just going to come out and be all business. And he finds Hayward cutting the net, who helps him out there as he kind of lost his progress, had to pick up the ball, pick up his dribble. But it worked out in the end, and so does that. It's another assist with 31 seconds left, and they pull away from the Clippers and win 113-99, a great victory. And in the end, he showed Magic Johnson what he could do in the assist game.
Apparently being called out by an NBA legend on social media is a pretty big motivator for you. as you really stepped up your game tonight. Care to make any comments about that situation?
Yeah, I heard about that comment, but my priorities ain't changing based on what anyone says, NBA legend or not. I've been working on that aspect of my game already, and tonight you saw some of that effort pay off, period. Nothing more than that.
There you go. Once again, Wally McGee handling it like a true professional there. He's not going to get caught up in all that. And, you know, he'll probably get mad respect for Magic Johnson for going out and showing him here. So we look at social media and, oh, there is something from Magic there. We'll get to in a second here. People calling for Wally to be MVP. Well, that's quite a task there if you were able to do that as a rookie. We'll see. You got Tony Parker laying down a challenge for double-double as they play the Spurs next. Man, we got to go back out on the road, and it starts with the Spurs. Ouch. Here we go, Magic Johnson. I'll be the first to admit that Wally World 42 proved me wrong with his performance tonight. If he keeps passing like that, his team is going to be just fine. There you go. So we got that respect he was looking for, and he handled it in the best way possible. So Magic is now, I guess what you would say, a fan of his game. And we move on to play the Spurs, man. It felt like we were just on that long road trip. We win a couple games at home, and now it's right back on the road again. And not just any old road game. We got to take on the Spurs, who are like third in the conference and pushing to make a run at the Thunder at the top of the conference. They're only a couple games out of that, I believe. So it's going to be a personal battle with Tony Parker tonight for Wally McGee, and now this is the kind of signature game, if they were able to win, maybe just propel them into that last playoff spot in the West. But let's see here, that shot doesn't go. Wally McGee with an offensive rebound. How about that? Ginobili looks perplexed that he gets called with the foul, but he does. And Wally will go to shoot two. He gets the first one to rattle on in, so let's see if he can make it 2-2 as Utah is going to try to absorb everything that the Spurs throw at him here in the first few minutes. We know they'll probably go for the knockout punch here at home, but there's a nice shot actually putting Utah up one by Wally McGee. He's got 4 points and 3 rebounds. How about those assists? Well, they'll have to wait. He hits the three right there, and that's a nice shot. San Antonio up by 2. There he goes, kicking it to Burks, and Burks is going to hit a 3, putting Utah back in the lead. This is going back and forth. Now it's San Antonio's lead. Parker trying to play some defense, but a nice pass to Gobert, and that's goaltending. Count the basket, count the assist for Wally McGee. It's his second of the game. Getting it to Burks here. What's Burks going to do? He's thinking about it. Oh, there he finds Wally McGee underneath, and that's a nice bucket right there, moving to an open space and getting the easy layup. 2-point Utah lead right now, and that shot's not going to go. It's a rebound for Wally. And that was not a smart pass, but he gets it back and resets things here, and wow. That was the Spurs. They just left it wide open like that. That's what you're going to do? Okay. Well, I don't know. Somebody missed an assignment. There was no help on the play. So Wally just takes it and stuffs it home. There you go. 46-45 lead right now. Now they respond and cut him off, but he gets the pass to assist right there. And it's a 3-point lead. Cut down to 1 now. Wally stumbles a bit, but gives it to Evans. He'll get the layup to go, and it's another assist. He's got 5. That ball kind of knocked in the air, but he does gather it and find Rudy Gobert, and it's another assist. So he made the best of kind of a tricky play right there as the ball popped right up in the air on him. Here he's going to, wow, that was kind of interesting. I thought he was going up for the layup, but instead he kind of goes behind the back, almost handing it off to Derek Favors, and he'll get the basket and the foul. So he gets a chance for a 3-point play. It's a 4-point lead here. Favors, the recipient of another Wally McGee pass. Things are looking good in the first half as they're keeping pace and maintaining a little bit of a lead here against the Spurs on the road. Oh, look at that. He got his double-double in the third quarter. And it's just a 1-point game when he strips Tony Parker, gets back to it, and slams it home. Nice job on the steal right there, getting their lead to 3 points, I believe, as Parker is pickpocketed by Wally McGee. So it's 73-72 right now, still third quarter. Parker, kind of an off-balance shot, and they'll give Wally credit for a defensive rebound there as he tipped it to a teammate. He's got his double-double, and he's one rebound short of a triple-double, but he's going to hit this shot big time there, quieting the crowd with a three-point lead. That's a steal, and we're going the other way. Third quarter's almost up. Look at that zip pass right there. Great pass for the assist, and that, I believe, is, what, 11 assists as Rush gets that one, and he is on his game again, is Wally McGee. Still that one rebound short of a triple-double, but most importantly, trying to keep a lead, and that three ball will help as he hits it. It's now 86-82. We fast forward a bit, and it's 90-84. Tim Duncan can't get his shot to go, and there it was, the rebound, the triple-double. Wally up court, and Splitter's got no time to play defense on him there. Fast break score, and the bench approves of that triple-double effort from Wally McGee. It's a 10-point lead now, kicking it to Favors, who gets the layup to go. Whew, 12-point lead. It looks like we might be winning a road game against the Spurs. How rare is that? Over to Hayward for three, and he's going to hit 105-90. The Jazz having a little fun here in the fourth quarter as they're pulling away. How rare is this? Jumper is good by Wally McGee, and these guys are fired up, having fun, playing some great ball. 28 points, 14 assists. Make it 15 assists right there with the pass to Cantor. And this game is all but over. A minute and a half left, getting this to Favors. He's going to lean and score. It's another assist. He outdid himself from the last game. 115-96 is your final. They win another game, this one against the Spurs on the road. The Jazz are red hot. Maybe they can make that playoff spot. I don't know. Only problem is Portland's been pretty hot as well and really not letting them gain any ground.
Coach, a very impressive performance tonight from the magician. Why do you think he was so successful against you tonight?
He was great. You know, we tried to do a couple of different things, but his play was better than anything we did defensively, that's for sure. He finished it off in fine fashion.
So Greg Popovich's crew threw everything they had at Wally McGee and couldn't keep him down. He gets a triple-double against the Spurs, leading his team to victory. Kind of a surprise upset right there. And now things don't get any easier. We got to go to Houston and take on Dwight Howard and the Rockets, Harden and company. Yeah, this is not going to be easy. Wow, this schedule really didn't shake out well for us. Coming down the stretch here, we probably should have done a better job early on. But then again, Wally wasn't a starter early on, so he's doing the best he can. Come on back as we chase down this playoff spot. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.